Phylum Echinodermata is the last of the major invertebrate phyla. All animals are exclusively marine and have adapted to various niches in the ecosystem. The adults are easily recognizable by their radial symmetry and the spine-like projections that are visible, giving the entire phylum its name. Scientists recognize 7,000 extant and 13,000 extinct species under this particular phylum. Most echinoderms become sexually mature within 2 to 3 years of their life. They are all gonochoric and many of them are hermaphrodites. The eggs and sperm cells are typically released into open water where fertilization takes place. The release of sperm and eggs is synchronized in some species, usually with regard to the lunar cycle. In other species, individuals may aggregate during a reproductive season, thereby increasing the likelihood of successful fertilization. Internal fertilization has currently been observed in 3 species of sea star, 3 brittle stars, and a deep water sea cucumber. Even at the abysmal depths where no light penetrates, synchronization of reproductive activity in echinoderms is surprisingly frequent. No other group of animals has such complicated metamorphosis in the course of their development. Development may be direct or indirect. In direct development, the larval stages are missing, while in indirect ones, various types of free-swimming larvae are formed. In each class, a few members are viviparous, that is, they brood their young ones in a sort of brood pouch on the surface of their body. The development of larva takes place in a typical deuterostomous fashion. In most cases, the characteristic free-swimming larvae develop externally, which are of great phylogenetic significance. Echinoderm larvae are strikingly bilaterally symmetrical in nature, in marked contrast to the radial symmetry present in adults. The larvae swims about by means of a ciliated band, which may be complicated by a number of short or long slender projections called arms from the body wall. Based upon the nature and position of the arms or their presence, larvae of different classes of Echinodermata may be distinguished. After a free-swimming planktonic existence, the bilateral larvae undergo metamorphosis in which the radial symmetry of the adult is developed. In different classes of echinoderms, different types of larvae complete their development. Let's look at each one by one. Class Astroidea and the Bipinnaria larva. 2 types of development occurs in the asterioids. The direct type has large yolk eggs and no free-swimming larval stage. The indirect type has a homolecithal egg with little yolk and a free-swimming larval stage. After hatching, the larva develops cilia and begins a free-swimming life. The larva feeds on diatoms as the alimentary canal is formed. The presence of powerful ciliary bands on the stomodial valves helps in feeding. 2 lateral longitudinal locomotory ciliated bands develop, which connect in front of the mouth or the stomodium, forming a preoral loop, and in front of the anus to form a preanal loop. Preoral loop later separates or in some cases develops independently into an anterior ciliated ring around the body. 3 lateral lobes or projections are also developed on each side of the body, bordered by these ciliary bands. This larva is known as Bipinnaria and develops in 2 to 7 days of the life cycle. Internal development of Bipinnaria. The tip of the larval archendron forms the mesenchyme and later gives rise to 2 lateral pouches which connect anteriorly to form a U-shaped coelom. Posterior ends of the lateral pouches pinch off to form the left and right somodeocels. Remaining anterior portion represents the hydrocele and axocele, but they never separate. The left hydrocele connects with the dorsal surface to form the hydropore. without ectodermal invagination. Ventrally, an ectodermal invagination meets the archintron and the larval gut is differentiated into mouth, esophagus, stomach and intestine. The blastopore remains as the larval anus. The axocele separates from the hydrocele and contributes to the stone canal. The madreporite or dorsal sac originates either from rearrangement of the mesenchymal cells or from ectodermal invagination, axohydrocele. Bipinnaria larva, after free swimming existence for a few weeks, changes to the next larval stage called a brachiolaria larva. Brachiolaria larva. The bipinnaria transforms into the brachiolaria larva, which develops three short arms at the preoral lobe known as the brachiolarial arms, one median and two lateral arms. They contain coelomic extensions and adhesive cells at their tips. An adhesive glandular area at their base acts as a sucker. Appearance of the sucker marks the beginning of metamorphosis. With the help of adhesive structures, the larva attaches onto some kind of object. The anterior region acts as a stalk for some time, while the posterior part, having the gut and coelomic chambers, converts into a young star. The star detaches itself and starts leading a free life. Some species cut short the development as a result of deletion of some larval stages. In Astropectin, the brachiolaria stage is missed, with the results being that bipinnaria directly metamorphosizes into an adult in 2 or 3 months. In Asterina, bipinnaria stage is omitted and the larva develops an adhesive apparatus as brachiolaria arms and suckers and undergoes metamorphosis. In Ludia, the giant star, a peculiar form is observed, which is called Bipinnaria astigeria. Class Ophiuroidae. Ophioplutus larva. Plutus is the free-swimming larva of brittle stars, which is commonly known as Ophioplutus larva. It is similar to Echinoplutus larva of echinoids, with the only difference being that the former has fewer arms than the latter. The posterior lateral arms are the longest and directed forward. After gastrulation, the arms develop gradually. Posterior lateral arms are formed first. After 4, 10 and 18 days, anterior lateral, post-oral and posterior dorsal arms develop respectively. Ciliated bands accompany the arms' edges. Internally, the larva contains coelomic chambers and the archintron. Internal development proceeds in the same way as in the other classes. While free-swimming metamorphosis of the larva starts, they begin no attachment stage. Tiny serpent stars sink to the bottom and begin its adult existence. Amphiura vivipara is a viviparous form, omitting the pluteus stage. In Ophinoplutus hexactus, development takes place in the ovary and the aborted plutus larva is devoid of arms and anus. Class Echinoidae. The Echinoplutus larva. The larva is formed after gastrulation. Gastrula becomes conical, one side of which flattens to form the oral surface. Stomodaenal invaginations communicate with the archintron and the gut is differentiated into mouth, esophagus, stomach and intestine. The blastopore remains as the larval anus. The larva begins to form projections which develop into arms. There are 6 arms, namely preoral, anterior lateral, anterior dorsal, post-oral, posterior-dorsal and posterior-lateral. The posterior-lateral arms are very short and directed outwards or backwards. In some cases, the anterior-dorsal arms may also not develop. Thus, a fully developed Echinoplutus may have 5 or even 4 pairs of arms instead of the typical 6. Tips of the arms are pigmented and are supported by calcareous skeletal rods. Locomotion is by the ciliated bands, which in some cases become thickened. Metamorphosis is extremely rapid, taking place in about an hour. There is no attachment stage in echinoids. Class Holothuroidea, Auricula larva. After gastrulation and formation of a coelomic sac and gut, the embryo becomes a free-swimming larva called Auricularia larva within 3 days. It is transparent, pelagic, about 0.5 to 1 millimeter in length. It swims about by a ciliated band which forms a pre-oral loop and a pre-anal loop. Internally, the larva has a curved gut with a stomach, hydrocele and left and right homoceles. Dolorelia larva. It's a transitional stage from Auricula and appears a barrel shaped and like the larva of crinoids. Continuous ciliated bands from 3 to 5 flagellated rings. Mouth is shifted to the anterior and anus to the posterior pole. Metamorphosis is gradual, during which it acquires 5 tentacles and 1 to 2 functional podia. Sometimes it is known as the Prentacula larva. After the appearance of more podia and tentacles, the sea cucumber settles into the sea bottom and leads an adult mode of life. Other forms of this class showed marked peculiarities in larval development. In Cucumaria, there is no auricular stage and the embryo directly develops into the Dolorelia larva. In others, both of these larval stages are omitted. The larva only swims about, having an oral ciliated shape. Class Crinoidea. It hatches as a free-swimming larva. The body has 4 to 5 ciliated bands with an apical sensory plate at the anterior end, provided with a bunch of cilia. There is an adhesive pit over the first ciliated band near the apical plate in the mid-ventral line. Between the second and the third ciliated bands lies the stomodium or the vestibule. The skeleton also develops at this larval stage. After the differentiation into prospective organs, the larva attaches itself and internal organs rotate at an angle of 90 degrees from ventral to posterior position. The larva forms a stalk and is now referred to as a cystadian or prentacrinoid larva, which after some time metamorphoses into an adult.